Roundels and rounded headlights, Hofmeister kinks and kidney grills. These car parts may not sound familiar, but you know them when you see them, even when they're zooming past at high speed. They're signature design cues on BMWs, each one helping the car stand out from the crowd. At least that's what this man hopes.
This is a project that the whole design team loves to get involved in.
Adrian Van Hooydonk is chief of design for the BMW group, and he says these elements help define the BMW brand, like the kidney grille, which has been a design staple since its first appearance in 1933.
It just helps make our cars very recognizable.
In an instant.
In an instant, exactly. Blink of an eye, or in the rearview mirror. That is very important to us, that you see that there's a BMW coming.
A grille is a pretty obvious design feature, but every line, trim, and surface, both inside and outside the car, is calculated precisely.
It doesn't just need to express beauty. Of course, that's another goal of ours. But it should entice people to come up close and even one day make a test drive and, of course, buy the product.
Another BMW design goal is to suggest movement. Crucial for a company that identifies itself as a maker of drivers' cars.
We make sure that every BMW is designed in such a way that is very clear in which direction it will move. Sounds logical, but not every car is designed that way. And it's also shown that this car is probably engineered to move quite fast. One element that does this is this feature line. When you follow this towards the rear, you see the shadow underneath this line?
It's a line of shadow that gets narrower as the car goes back.
It's almost like the tail of a comet. It's done for this purpose, to give the car a clear direction in which it's moving, even while it's standing still.
The brand's most famous design elements were developed here, inside the company's Munich studio. Few cameras have been inside, but we were given access to look at the process that begins 3 years before a new BMW hits the showroom floor. First, BMW stages a sketch competition among its 450 designers in Munich, Los Angeles, and Singapore, laying out very simple guidelines for the next model in the pipeline.
When you talk about the front of a car, you often talk about a face.
Lead exterior designer Karim Habib says they relate elements of a car to parts of the human body, like when he compares fenders to quadriceps.
We create a volume over the rear wheel, and that is actually, it's literally looks, feels, and acts, if you will, like a muscle.
Sort of the, the way an athlete's leg muscles.
Absolutely.
The source of his power.
Absolutely. A lot of times it's part of our inspiration. We often talk about sort of an athlete in a suit, and that character has a lot to do with what BMW stands for.
Designers like Christian Bauer are given the freedom to interpret the guidelines using whatever might spark their imaginations.
What's an example of a really good, really interesting inspiration for you?
The design or the appearance of Apple products.
Apple products?
Yeah, yeah. Well, we'll have to look what is cool for everyone and what is hip.
Next, designers pitch their ideas to the management team.
It's a big presentation. Everyone puts the sketches and the general ideas on the wall in a big studio over there, and everyone presents what the goal was for his design.
Roughly four ideas are chosen to move on to the next phase, where computer images and life-size clay models are generated from the sketches, all of it scrutinized by Van Hooydonk.
We want to look at it one-to-one, and sometimes we want to actually touch the shape because the hand is even more perceptive to surface change than the eye. In this way, we can control the shapes that we have developed to the finest detail.
Your hands see better than your eyes.
Exactly, yeah.
Well, I guess if you make a mistake, you got extra clay, right?
You give it a bit of curvature and then pull it down with a bit more force.
Wow, that is not as easy as it looks.
The clay model is scanned and updated regularly on computers, so engineers can test and develop in tandem with the designers.
So while the designer is still creating with the model maker the shape, we are already sending data to the engineers so they can test aerodynamics or feasibility in metal and give us feedback.
The management team whittles down the four designs to the final two, which go before BMW's board of directors. one is chosen to become the next BMW. Then it's up to engineers and factory workers to turn all the chosen design elements into plastics, wood, and metal. Perhaps no element of the car's design is more critical than this, the BMW logo. Here on the production line, about 50 yards before they turn on the engine, they place it on the hood, and with one hit, it's a BMW car.
I would imagine the first time you see your design built and you think about the amount of money and commitment and labor that went into turning this into metal, I mean, that's got to make you want to cry.
I'm not going to say on television that I got teary-eyed, but actually I did. Yeah. Yeah, no, it is definitely very emotional for every designer. It's often a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
The design process is as exciting as it is stressful. Adrian von Hooydonk knows the pressure well. 10 years after beginning his career at BMW, he penned the lines for a controversial 7 Series under then-design chief Chris Bangle. Although the car was blasted by reviewers who dubbed the large back end the Bangle Butt, it broke sales records and profoundly influenced car design for years. Van Hooydonk admits designing for the future can be a chess game.
You're designing cars that won't be on the market for 3 years, and they're going to be on the market 10 years from now. How do you make sure they're not going to be like we look at our father's ties, you know? How do you know they're still going to be culturally relevant, visually relevant?
Well, first of all, I don't wear ties, as you might have noticed, so I stay out of that trouble. But, okay, and this is, of course, the most difficult part of my job. I can never be 100% sure, but I think as a designer and as a design team, we have very fine antenna for what is going to happen in the future. We are in touch with other industries as well, and from that we slowly gather what people might want to do in their lives in 3 to 5 years from now, what other products will be surrounding us, and this is all a basis for the choices that our customers are going to make in the future.
Redesigning a BMW is challenging enough. Imagine doing it for the company's most exclusive brand and the world's most demanding buyers.
We've done a couple of cars for customers with a white leather floor.
Yep. A white leather floor.
A white leather floor.
$1 million in motion when we return.
Set up for sexual